Example 1. A timber strut is 7 meters long and has a uniform rectangular cross section 200 millimeters by 400 millimeters. It is pinned at both ends to stop. Young's modulus E equals 15,000 newtons per millimeter squared. Calculate the buckling load. Because it is pinned at both ends, K equals 1. Therefore, LE equals 1 into L. Because IYY is the smaller value of I, this strut will buckle about the Y axis. In our example 1a, if the above column is prevented from buckling about the y-axis by side walls, check whether it could buckle about the x-axis. Check whether it could buckle about the x-axis. Radius of gyration about x-axis equals 0.288 d equals 115.2 millimeters. ऐसा लेकर क्या? इससे लग बिगर क्या अंदर नहीं है? नहीं मैं अंदर नहीं हूँ.
तो
अभी d क्या है? मुकाद्दे के लिए पिन अंदर नहीं है. मेरे को d नहीं. Right. Therefore, slenderness ratio lambda x equals 7000 over 115.2 equals 60.8 less than 100. Therefore, the strut is not slender and will not fail by buckling. Example 1b. Example 1b. If buckling about the y-axis is restrained by a horizontal beam at mid-height of the column, find about which axis buckling will take place and hence find the buckling load. And buckling about the y-axis is shown by the dotted lines, and therefore for y-axis buckling the effective length becomes half the original length, that is 3500 millimeters. But for buckling about x-axis the effective length still remains at 7000. Can we find that full length ekak pakkalena ne 9 kg. Lambda x equals effective length over R x x. Right. Therefore, lambda x is greater than lambda y, and buckling will take place about the x-axis. Thank you. 10^6. 8, 9. Therefore, P equals I squared V I over in steel design. The members are named according to the cross-sectional shapes of the members. Thus, an I-beam will have a cross-section in the shape of an I. Calculating Rxx, Ryy, Ixx, Iyy, etc. for such beams will take much time. Therefore, these values we can obtain by steel design tables. Right, etiquette.